Yeah. I can't drink my coffee whenever I'm digging the earth.
Beneath any science fiction, there is always a reality.
If there was no mining, we could survive.
Mm-hmm. How old is mining?
Yeah, I don't know.
Hello.
Hello.
This is my colleague Nasser Madani. We work together in Nazarbayev University. Mm-hmm. He's an expert in geostatistics.
Thank you, Amunso. This is my colleague, Dr. Amunso Kofi Adoko. And we are working together in the School of Mining and Geosciences in Nazarbayev University in the mining engineering program. And he's an expert in geomechanics.
Mine geomechanics.
Mine geomechanics.
To be precise.
To be precise, exactly.
Nasser,
yes.
I hear that there mm-hmm. are chances that animals can be used to explore mineral. Is that true?
Look, the thing is that some mineral deposits, in the nature, they are injecting some special minerals into the waters, into the plants. And we have many animals that are living in the nature, like goats, sheep, and mm-hmm. they are eating from these plants. They are drinking from waters. And after that, this lead to concentration of some element in their body. So just the sampling process from their tissue, from their furs, from their blood can trace these elements, the concentration of these elements, and then it can lead you to the mineral deposit. Simple. What is the hardest mineral on the earth?
Diamond is the hardest mineral, okay? So by hard, we mean the ability, okay, mm-hmm. of the mineral, right, to be scratched.
Okay.
With mm-hmm. another mineral. Mm-hmm. So if you take all the mineral together, only diamond, okay, can scratch any other minerals.
Oh, yeah.
For instance, if you take calcite, okay, you can use, for instance, copper coins and just scratch, which means calcite is less hard than a copper.
Yep.
So a diamond is on the top. Can you tell me whether mining is a dirty job or a good job?
Most people think that the mining is a dirty job. Yeah, because maybe it was true a long time ago when our ancestors were working in the mine and they were extracting the minerals or coal, and you could see some photos from mm-hmm. a very long time ago that the people were dirty and whatever. But the thing is that today, these days, in fact, thanks to the development of knowledge and technology, mm-hmm. I can sit in my office in the city and I can remotely dig the earth. Mm. Easy. So I will be clean. Mm-hmm. I can drink my coffee whenever I'm digging the earth.
Good.
And
good.
I'm clean like now. Right.
What do you think about the continent shifting?
While we are sitting here, the continents are moving. Yes. And so maybe you cannot feel it, but these very tiny movements lead to a concentration of pressure on the continents, and after that it leads to a very big earthquake. So the earthquake is the accumulation of the pressures of the very tiny movement of the continents. Yeah, of course. Well, the thing is that in Atlantic Ocean, the two continents are shifting apart, and for example in Middle East, for instance, mm-hmm. a Arabian plate mm-hmm. is just moving toward the Iranian plate, and this Arabian plate is going down to the Iranian plate, and this you can see some earthquakes. Yeah, afterwards.
How rich Kazakhstan is in terms of mineral?
I cannot say this precisely, but I know that uranium. Yeah, Kazakhstan is the biggest producer of uranium, for instance. And coal and
gold
as
zinc.
Zinc, yeah, yeah.
Copper.
Zinc. Copper, yes. And yeah, they have a lot of elements, but they have not yet discovered. Yeah, this is the
okay.
This is a problem. That Kazakhstan is a good mining country, but they have not yet discovered.
Mm-hmm. How old is mining?
Yeah, I don't know. Very old.
Very old. Eh?
Yes.
Yeah.
As quite old.
As old.
Extremely
as
old.
Human being started mining somehow. An example is the Stone Age. They need to get some stone. I mean, cutting stone is part of mining.
Mm-hmm. Okay? Yeah.
It's rock excavation, and then they move to the Bronze Age, right? Mm-hmm. When they start dealing with mineral metals. Processing of metal, okay, till up to the 15th century, when the first book, okay, on mining has been published.
Okay.
So it means mining is very, very old. Why do we have a different color in gems, stone gems?
Gemstones actually is the output of the concentration and some activity of water with some elements. So for example, in some area that the concentration of some elements gets high, so it leads to have a different color for gemstones. For example, if you see that the gemstone is brown, it means that there might be a little bit of iron in it. Yeah, or maybe the concentration of the, I don't know, maybe if this is green, maybe this is the concentration of copper in it. Yeah, yeah, this is some chemical activities that have happened, and this lead to this
good
kind of gems. The future of natural resources is mining, because we need lithium and chromium for the batteries, for the electrical cars.
Do you know that the first mineral, okay, to be unearthed, to be exploited since ever, are gold and copper?
Oh, really?
Not okay. Silver, gold and copper.
Gold and copper. So, do you know that, for example, whenever you go to the beach, for example, you go to the Caspian Sea, and you see the sands, and some soils over there. You know that? How old are they?
No.
Maybe for more than 4,000 million years ago. Yeah. Very, very old. Yes.
This sand from
the sand that you are touching is coming from maybe 4,000 million years ago.
Okay. Yeah. Right. Interesting.
So as I mentioned, is that the future is mining, and so the mining activity never dies. So apply to mining.
Mining engineers have good future, good prospect in terms of work, employment, here in Kazakhstan or anywhere in the world.